मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी द फर्दर टॉपिक ऑफ क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ प्लांट्स. इन माई लास्ट वीडियो वी हैड स्टडीड अबाउट डिविजन थैलोफाइटा. नाउ टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी अबाउट डिविजन ब्रायोफाइटा. लेट्स बिगिन विथ दिस टॉपिक ऑफ ब्रायोफाइटा. विद्यार्थी मित्रांनो, तुम्ही पावसाळ्याच्या दिवसांमध्ये ओलसर भिंती नक्कीच पाहिले असतील, आणि त्या ओलसर भिंतींवरती येणारी जी वनस्पती असते ती कोणत्या गटात येऊ शकते? ब्रायोफायटामध्ये येऊ शकते. आता याचे आपण वैशिष्ट्य जाणून घेऊया. व्हॉट आर द कॅरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ ब्रायोफायटा? फर्स्ट कॅरेक्टरिस्टिक्स, दिस ग्रुप ऑफ प्लांट्स आर कॉल्ड एज एन एम्फीबियन्स. वाय दे आर कॉल्ड एज एन एम्फीबियन्स? बिकॉज दे ग्रो इन मॉइस्ट सॉइल एज वेल एज दे ऑल्सो नीड वॉटर फॉर प्रोडक्शन. सेकेंड पॉइंट, these plants are multicellular and autotrophic. Third one, they reproduce by spore formation. Fourth one, they do not have special tissues for conduction and of water and food. These are the general characteristics of bryophyta. Now let's begin in detail with taking an example of moss. Moss is also called as an funarium. If you observe this picture or diagram, you can see that there are root like structure. This is not a true root. It looks like a root, but it is called as an rhizoids. Then here also same, you can see leaf like structure, but these are not the true leaves. These are leaf appendages. This will be called as an leaf appendages. And at the top you can see the stalk and last part, that is called as an capsule. This capsule contains spores. During favorable conditions, when this capsule breaks open, the spores will be liberated out. And from each spores, a new type of plant would be given or reproduced. So similarly, you can take one example moss. Second example is Markensia. In Markensia also, you can see that it is a flat ribbon-like structure. And at the base there are rhizoids, and just at the tip of this you can have a capsule. And same case, in the capsule what will be stored? Spores will be stored. So when it is liberated out, each spores will give rise to a new type of plant over here. So in both the cases you can say that they carry out asexual type of reproduction. Similarly, they doesn't have a special conducting tissue. Now, which type of conducting tissues are there in this type of funaria? Xylem. Xylem is responsible to absorb water, and phloem is responsible to absorb the food. So here in this case, both xylem and phloem are absent. That is why we can say that they do not have special tissues for conduction of water and food. So these are the general characteristics of bryophyta. Similarly, now we are going to study about the next division called as a division pteridophyta. Now what are the common characteristics of pteridophyta? Plants have well developed root, stem and leaves. Root, stem and leaves. Secondly, they have a conducting tissue, that means xylem and phloem will be present over here. Then they reproduce asexually by spore formation. Now here also we will take an example of fern. Fern, yalas apan marathitun nechechi vanaspati manuya. If you observe the fern, there are true roots over here. Then there are leaves also present. Now if you pluck one of the leaf, and at the back of the leaf you can see this round shape structure. This round shape structure will be called as an sporangium or sori. Sori, in that sori you can have sporangium. So when the sori breaks open, the sporangia will fall down, and each sporangia will give rise to a new type of fern plant. So here also we can see asexual reproduction. So what is the special characteristics of this pteridophyta? That presence of sori, and in that sporangia will be present. So today we had completed about two types of division, division Bryophyta and division Pteridophyta. In next lecture, we will continue our topic. So thank you very much.